Unfortunately, his son also had married Ahab's daughter. How do you do this? It's so evil. I said, your people are my people. So let's go. So they went. And on the trip, they walked 7 days in the wilderness. And there was no water. And now they were thirsty. They were devastated. And then the wicked king who did not know God. If you check the statements of people who don't know God, clothing of Ram. So he was doing this as long as Ahab was on the throne. But when Ahab died, he said, we want to have our independence. We will not pay that money again. But his brother who came on the throne could not contend with them. But this guy, on the third year, he decided to go and to put the pressure on the Moabites so that they pay tolls to him. This afternoon, if your property or your family's property or your family's inheritance had been confiscated by people who have seized it, we are coming to Jehovah Jireh to pray that God will restore unto us. Instead of him to repent and pray, he went and called Jehoshaphat. And said, Jehoshaphat, you are the king of Judah. Please come and help me. And then we also join with Edom, the king of Edom. So that we go as three. Party three. The Israel, Judah, and Edom. And go and fight against the king of Moab. And put pressure on them. But Jehoshaphat has not learned from his lesson. He is a godly king. But he is easily enticed by bad friendship and bad alliance. His father, the father of Jehoram, who is Ahab, you know that Ahab is a bad king.
Why would you say Ahab?
And he called you to go and fight the people of Aram. And he disguised himself. But for Jehoshaphat, he was putting on the king's clothing. And then when the battle became hot, the king said, don't kill anybody. If you see the king of Israel, kill him. But the king of Israel has disguised himself. But Jehoshaphat was wearing his kingly dress into a battle which is an evil battle. There are people who come to church. They disguise themselves. And they will push you to evil. They are evil people that will not show their face. But they will hide their face and push you to go and do evil. And at the end of it all, you will receive the curse. They are evil leaders. They will not come to presbytery meeting to air their views. But they will stay behind and instigate you. If you go to a meeting, go and disturb the pastor. Go and disturb the meeting. But why is it that the person is not doing it? At the end of the day, you will be instigated. You will bear the consequence. There are people who are evil. You should tell them that what you are doing is evil. They are living with a woman who they have not married. But you are still friends with them. And you want to eat with them. You want to drink with them. You want to joke together with them. And you don't tell them that what they are doing is bad. Oh, I'm preaching where you don't like. I'm preaching. You know you are moving with people. And the people are evil people. But you have created an alliance, unnecessary alliance. Bible says, blessed is he who does not walk in the ways of sinners, nor sit in the street of scornful, but his delight is in the word of God, and he meditates on it day and night. And in it, God will prosper that person. So if you have a negative friend, an alliance, evil person, cut the person off your life. Jehoshaphat could not do. And then on the battle, when they saw him with the royal clothes, they started chasing him. And they started shouting. And yem yo. And yem yo.
I'm not the one. I'm not the king.
I mean, I'm not a king of Israel.
I feel
now
bet
here.
You are now screaming.
And then the people retrieved. And God said, what you are doing is evil. But he repented. Years later, his son had come on the throne. You are the one who keep the covenants of God. You worship the Lord. And this son is not a worshiper of God. And he has called you to join an alliance to go and fight a battle. You couldn't learn of yesterday's lesson and begin to follow him. They say first fool is not a fool, but second fool. So when they started that trip, they went and called the king of Edom. And said, which way should we pass? So let's pass through Edom. Because your horses are my horses. Your people are my people. But for Ruth, he said, your people will be my people because your people worship God.
Now Ruth, your car said,
how can your people be my people if my people are worshiping God and your people are worshiping idol? Unfortunately, his son also had married Ahab's daughter. How do you do this? It's so evil. I said, your people are my people. So let's go. So they went. And on the trip, they walked 7 days in the wilderness. And there was no water. And now they were thirsty. They were devastated. And then the wicked king who did not know God. If you check the statements of people who don't know God, anything evil comes, anything good thing comes, they say, oh, it is my strength that has accomplished it. But every time evil thing comes, they blame it to God. God has not said anything. But immediately he saw the evil that is coming. Say, for 7 days there is no water. God has called these three kings to give them into the hands of Moab. And then Jehoshaphat said, is there not a prophet in the land? All this while, they were going to a battle without knowing the knowledge of God concerning the battle. Are you undertaking a project and you have not asked the mind of God? Are you going to a marriage and you have not asked the mind of God? Because you have seen the person with the money, you've seen the person with the beauty, you've seen the money with ballet paper, so you want to go and marry. But have you asked the counsel of God? Jehoshaphat said, is there no prophet in the land? I'm asking, is there no prophet in the land? God honors the word of his servant and performs the counsel of his messenger. Believe in the prophets and you shall prosper. So is there not a prophet in the land? And then one of the kings, king of Israel's servants said, Elisha, the son of Shaphat, who poured water in the hands of Elijah. What does it mean? It means that this guy, Jehoshaphat, didn't know Elijah. But Jehoshaphat might have heard about Elijah, the God who brings fire, the God who judged the Baal prophets, the man of God who was raptured into heaven. So if there is somebody who had poured water in the hands of Elijah, then the word of God will be with that person. Pouring water in the hands of the man of God, it is serving the man of God. Many people think if they are serving man of God, they are downgrading themselves. But in serving the man of God, you are receiving an anointing which is upon the man of God. And that anointing will come and empower you. He said, there is, the guy served Elijah, some Bible scholars say 21 years, pouring water on the hands of Elijah. An officer, who have you served? A church member, who have you served? Which of the men of God have you served? Which one have you poured water in the hands of Elijah? When it comes to service, people feel they are too big. But in the service of God, there is nothing too big. We are pastors who have run through this church from the inception of the church. Apostle Dr. F.K. Bonso, Apostle Dr. Bediakun. We have gotten Apostle Dr. M.K. into me. Apostle Yadom. Apostle Sion. Apostle Kwe. All of us are servant. We are men of God. Pastor Yabiso said, Pastor Makwabuatin, Pastor Bemesa, Pastor Akwesia Pia, Pastor Kujo Frimpombuatin, and men of God who are serving this. Which of them have you served? It is not dressing to come to church. But if you serve the Lord, the Bible says, humble yourself under the mighty hand of the Lord. And in his time, he will exalt you. You see, people in Europe, you don't know how to catch anointing. In people in Africa, you go there, At times you think it is overtribing or exaggeration. Even your sweat, somebody is been appointed to clean your sweat for you if you are preaching. But we say this is overtribing. We are Pentecostals, so we are living simple. But that didn't defeat the fact that you have to serve in the house of God. Even Germany here, recently we went, last year we went to a meeting in her house. It was all pastors meeting. Pastors in Germany.
Germany
from all churches, Pentecostal pastors. And I was supposed to preach, they call it an empowerment service. And the one who was doing the conducting the program is a pastor from this evangelist, Rehan Bonke Church.
So far now, a Rehan Bonke,
and is the president of the MPP in Deutschland.
Now, no, MPP.
So whilst he was doing introduction, want to invite me. I, for his caliber, I expected him to just call me, and I just, you know, our simplicity, hand over. I come to the microphone to preach. He said, "Our man of God is here. Our apostle is here. I'm not worthy to even introduce him. I'm coming to take his Bible. And then I'm ushering him into the pulpit. And I'm going to take his
sandwich."
And then he came and took my Bible. I said, "Oh, Pastor." And then he took my iPad and brought it to the pulpit. Took my handkerchief.
Now,
I said, "I want to salute me. I want us to stand and begin to sing a song to welcome me." I said, "But we believe in simplicity, but he wants to tap into some anointing that he never knew." And he came and took my Bible to the pulpit and introduced me before I came to preach. But I'm not talking about this camera of Brazil kind of thing. It's not that it wasn't doing camera of Brazil, but people see you and they koto. But genuinely, they are not submissive. Fake humility. But God wants genuine humility. He said, "Elisha, the son of Shaphat, who poured water in the hands of Elijah." He said, "The word of the Lord was to me." When they got there, said, "What do I have to do with you?" "Go to your father's prophets and the mother, the prophets of your mother." I did not mean Jehoshaphat. I wouldn't have looked into your face. There are certain times human beings, some people, because of them, you have to be quiet. I was an elder of the church, and I was offended because some of the people were not doing things right. About instruments, and there, some of the leaders were not doing things. So I was offended. I was just, I fled up. And the way my temper was, I knew those people that nobody could control me. So on my back, one of the elders went, "Oni." And I turned myself and I realized that this person was the one who trained me and taught me how to preach. When I saw his face, then I came down. Because I give him all the respect. Because I know that this guy is the one who picked me from nowhere and brought me into the work of the Lord and taught me how, even how to preach. And because of him, I kept quiet. And said, because of him, I will not speak. I will not speak. This is what you must see somebody in the church and say, because of you, even if I have a strife with my husband, a strife with my wife, a strife with my fellow neighbor, because of your face, I will not speak. But there are people who never fear God. They will see even apostle there, they see pastor there, and they strive and they begin to insult, curse, and do everything and fight. There was a time I have to suspend a lady who came and fought on the pulpit. But the prophet himself, he respected the king, the king of Judah. And said, your name is Jehoshaphat. Means God will judge. And so because of you, I want to after answer this man. And say, bring me some musicians. You see, musicians bring the presence of God. So musicians who play shabu shabu. Shabu shabu is to play here, get 2 euro, play here, get 10 euro, play here, get 50 euro. But from, because they knew that their father David could play instruments skillfully. And evil spirit will go out of the people. I pray that our singers, our musicians, who operate under the anointing of the Lord, that if we come to service, even this afternoon, we were stopping the music and the music was not stopping. This is the flow of the Holy Spirit. It is not mechanical generating praise, but spontaneous praise coming from the Holy Ghost. I pray that this anointing will fall upon our musicians. That when we come to church and then the music is being played, we can see God working on behalf of our people in the name of Jesus. Bring me some musicians and let me play. So the musicians started playing. I don't know the song that they play, but there are some songs that bring the presence of God. There are some songs that bring the anointing of God. Oje. To me what? To me what? To me what? There are some songs that bring the presence of God. To me what? To me what? To me what? Jesus. For what would bra my enfa? And yet where to ma? Eradie. Yeah. Oh, oh, oh,
my father, yes,
this song bring the presence of God. So play some music for me. Anointed music. Not music that can bring people's spirit down, but anointing of music that can inspire us and bring us into a place that we can have that anointing. And while they were playing the music, and they were playing the music, and they were playing the music, soon soon bear with Juma, soon soon bear with Juma, soon soon. Bear with you, man. So soon, do I feel
so soon. So soon. Oh no, no, yeah, quite cheerful. Hallelujah, so soon. Hey, so soon.
So soon.
Hey, so soon. So soon. So soon. And while they were singing this song, it said, "Thus saith the Lord, Thus saith the Lord, make ditches in the valley." It is crazy if you are following instructions of God. It doesn't make sense. But miracles of God will never make sense. But it is power. He said, now dig ditches in the valley so I could see the children of Israel and the children of Judah and the children of Edom taking their horses and digging ditches. This afternoon, you will dig some ditch. The money is not there. But God is saying, you dig a ditch. And faith comes by hearing. And hearing the word of God. And they began to dig dishes. And say, as they dug their dishes. And they said, Thus saith the Lord, you will not see wind. You will not see rain. In those parts of the world, if rain is coming or if rain is about to fall, there will be some cloud that will bring some whirlwind, and that will tell you that the cloud is bringing some rain. But the same cloud, the same dry weather, the same dry marriage, the same dry financial status, the same dry residential status, you will not see wind, the same dry stomach, and doctors are telling you cannot give birth. You will not see anything, but the beaches that you have dug, you will not see rain, but the valley. The valley will be full of water. I prophesy to each and every one of us, every dire situation, you may be in the valley. Valley talks about depression. Valley talks about depression. Desert talks about dryness of your life. And you are expecting rain to come. You are expecting some wind to blow. You will not shake. You will not fall down. But the word of God, God will corner his word. The valley that you have dug the ditches in it, it shall be full of water. And the Bible says, in the night, at the evening sacrifice, let me take my time and do this. In the book of Ezra, we heard that In the evening sacrifice, Ezra knelt down and prayed to the God of heaven. There is something about evening sacrifice. The Bible says, when Elijah and the Baal prophets met, they say in the time of sacrifice, he said, pour water upon the sacrifice, let it overflow. But our God, who honors the time of the sacrifice, will perform a miracle. This is the time. This is the time that God is about to perform a miracle in your life. The Bible says in the evening sacrifice, when they have offered the sacrifice, John and Peter, when they were coming, it was the sacrifice, it was the hour of prayer. And then they told the cripple man, silver and gold we do not have, but what we have is what we give unto you. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, rise up and walk. And the guy stood up and leaped and danced. This afternoon is an afternoon of sacrifice. It's an afternoon that God wants to meet you. Divinity is meeting humanity. God is meeting human being in the form of your need. And when they offered the evening sacrifice, the rain didn't come from that place, but the rain started from Edom. The Bible says, I will lift up my eyes to the hills. From whence cometh my help? My help comes from the Lord, who made heaven and earth. And then water began to fall in the land of Edom, and then begin to sweep and begin to fill all the dishes. You will not see water, you will not see rain, you will not see wind, but in the morning the valleys and the dishes will be filled with water. In the morning, when the Edomites woke up and they saw the water, and the sun is shining on the water, God changed their perception. You see, the other time there were four lepers. They were going and God amplified their steps. But for these people, they saw it as a blood, pool of blood. And said the three kings had killed themselves with sword. Let us go and take the spoil. So they were rejoicing to go and take the properties. When they got there, they didn't know that the Israelites were alert, and they carried the battle to them. They killed them and they destroyed them. This afternoon, whoever is coming to take your stuff by your prayer, let God arise and his enemies be scattered in the name of Jesus. And while they were destroying them, the king of Moab went into his reserve and brought 700 horsemen, chariots with soldiers. And this reserve were his last card. And they thought they would break Edom. But when they went there, they crushed him. Whoever shall come against your life, this Jehovah Jireh prayer, that person will be crushed. That person will be crushed. But there's something that up to now, theologians and people don't understand. Elijah said, God will give the Moabites into your hands. But the king realized something. When they were losing, he went and took his son, his eldest son, who will reign in his stead. And place it on the wall. And those people, they believe in human sacrifice. And God has warned them that don't
mingle yourself with human sacrifice. If you do, I'll turn my face away. Listen to this piece well. It can release you. It can release you from every stress that you are in. The first son, the eldest son, he placed him on the wall. And he sacrificed him. Not even to God. But to Molech. Which God detests about that. But when the man did that, God changed the battle. And then there was indignation in Israel. And there Israel had to run away. And that was the end of war. Why? Somebody has sacrificed to idol. And then you said you give them into your hands. But why didn't you put them into your hands totally?
God saw.
That in his infinite wisdom and in infinite plan, in the fullness of time, he will bring his one and only son. And he will son and come and die on the cross. He will not forsake his son. He will not hinder his son. But he will release his son. That is all that he has. But he's going to give it to humanity. So that we will be saved. So if a king who didn't know him, and his last card was his son, and would do that, God said, this guy, although he doesn't know me, he has done something in my plan. Let me change the battle gear. That is why when you come to church, if you're last, you give it to the Lord. The Lord changed the battle for your sake. I pray that this Jehovah Jireh, God will provide for you. God will provide for you. You will not see wind. You will not see rain. But the valley and the dishes will be filled with water. May God fight your battles for you. May you also offer unto the Lord, and the Lord will answer you and show you many things that you do not know. May you be blessed as God provide for us, in Jesus' name.
Oh, you can do better. So, yeah.
Then on Sunday too, we are going to also have a Lord's Supper. Get some bread in the course of the week. Get some zaft or some juice so that you could also dine with the Lord from the comfort of your homes. And my room, if you say, Ebe ye radia di die, da e ye e da kwa siada. E chile kwa siada ebe ya, ebe ye e radia e di die. Na ye ni e radia atu nse di die. Wabre e guswa ye buwa ya hon, ne ye ni nami e kotu nse di die no. Mesre o, abra u guswa uko e jume ya, abra u guswa uko ni jana uko krumi ya. Mwadiya ne pe abo jobi, ne pe anudie mi suka ho anasem pose en krakasi bi na obi nyampo a faka ho na ye mompa ye muso na ye ni erade ntun senidi e mane nyawo se enam se ye wo fie ntino ye ntimi ne erade ntun senidi ye gusua ye ne mo wa hase ye gusua ye ne mo etna ha akosi anwumre onyame onka mo pa na onya mo adom abra me mama wo etie enyum kakra na fe ye didi edi ho so so abra mu yi osoa ne fa ofidie no eto ha.
Jatano edi nkunim Kristo na hweni mojegu amaye Osrodom na twashia ridi ehusi Osrodom na twashia resene nyunyam ride busiemu jatano edi nkunim Kristo na hweni mojegu amaye Amen usenase Amen usen ayeyi Amen, Mose Nasi, Christo Nefini Mojegu Amayen. Amen, Mose Nasi, Amen, Mose Ayeyi. Amen, Mose Nasi, Christo Nefini Mojegu Amayen.
Mom. mountain team, mountain team, and mamu him da. Now, monk or so, ewo on Yamia Juman, be steadfast and immovable, abiding in the work of the Lord. We are still doing the work of God. We are still doing the work of God here in Pentecost, Germany. We have realized that there are a lot of people who during this corona pandemic, they are suffering. Many have lost their jobs. Many are having severe financial difficulties. For this very reason, the church has taken it upon itself to also help out some people who are so in need, some people who need financial assistance. If you know such a person, if you are also such a person, please channel this to your presiding elder or your district pastor so that we can know and then we can come to your aid. Mr. Obraye ye nyame adwuman. Obraye gusua ye ye nyame adwuman. Enu nso ka ho bi. Ye hu nso corona bre yi mu amamfo bebre na won ho akire won. Sika sem wa ye dina ma won. Esa nse nipa ne bebre ahwire won adwuma. Na we na Church of Pentecost no. Ye nso ye fatu ye nso na ka kre bi ye betumi ye bo biara no. Ye so ye ya bo a. Ti se wonim obi an ho akire ne wo sa kwane so. Ana nse won nso ho akire wo sa kwane so amepa chaw. Fafa o praise adin ye da so ana sa o district pastor so. Na ye hunu se unya emwe bi etisa na district na wo mu no o matimi akowo mu a sa kwane so aso ne yenam na ye yesese se asore bebi anase obi ko wona se opese adwuma ye ye oboa ye wo mu a ono so so obetimi enso so e di afa the prince ani enda so anase ne sofo so anase mu amu hambog ne die mu ba head officer Debia no ye waha say, say ye beji mumwa, na yesu ye diakwaye mwa ama afofrono. Please, 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 if there is someone who also want to help us in this job, who also want to help us so that we can help others in the church, please, you can channel your donations through your district pastors or also through your presiding elders. And those in Hamburg, you can also bring it to the head office. And then we also would use it to help others who are in dying need. Onyame onshiramu, onyame onshiramu pa. Sena meka yeno, mimininda, Jehovah Jireh. Jehovah Jireh, ayene ye nsuma fwa, aposu yebe neza niyo daikwe. Ena ebe yesa Jehovah Jireh no, ne nasem ni biya omae, ewo Jehovah Jireh biye etwe mu, ena yetie yeno. This coming Saturday we'll be having Jehovah Jireh, and then we'll be having it with our Apostle Ebenezer Ni Odakwe, the national head for Pentecost, the Church of Pentecost Germany. And then some of that was one of the messages that he gave in other Jehovah Jireh. But this coming Saturday, we'll be having it live here from the studios, and then we'll be bringing it to you on Friday. Friday too, we'll be having service. So don't forget, please don't forget, Friday we'll be having service. Friday is 1st May, and then it is a holiday. We're having service here in the studio from 11 to 1, and then we'll be bringing it to your various homes. Yeah, but yes, some deaf yada, a di animui, a ye may bosom and a day di kind of yet or some webbrow, ewo ufiemu, and ma urefi, do bako pepe penny as I say, don't quote na ya pong. And ye best sign I di a radiated dien so, consider a bay, ma rinfi, se a radiated dieno, a brau coswana, codigiano, brau codium codigiano, codium cototon, your mano, now what your panu be, and now se crackers be a show, unumum, would you be a radiated dieno, now afe, wape, and only be a day, a come home. Please, whilst you go to do your shopping, your grocery shopping, please buy bread and then a certain wine or soft so that we can use it to do our Lord's Supper on coming Saturday. May the Lord bless you so much.
Pentecost Radio, Germany.
Yeah. Yeah, you're free, baby. You're hot.